Greetings to everyone out there and welcome back to Around the Clock. And in a recent investors Q&A briefing, the global president of Nintendo, Shuntaro Furukawa, has given us a brief summary of what we can expect for the Nintendo Switch from 2020 and beyond. That's right everyone, as reported by NintendoEverything.com, we've got a rundown of what Shuntaro Furukawa has stated. But first, he was asked these questions. What are your thoughts on the business cycle based on the trends for Nintendo Switch at the end of the third holiday season? Do you believe that the Nintendo Switch lifecycle will be different from the past cycles? And if so, do you think the business can expand even after growth in unit hardware sales has plateaued somewhat? Or do you intend to prolong the lifecycle by diversifying the family with more hardware variations like Nintendo Switch Lite? And then Shuntaro Furukawa has stated this. With Nintendo Switch about to begin its fourth year, the situation does feel a little different from the home consoles we've offered in the past. In addition to Nintendo Switch being a home console, you can take it on the go. We're also offering Nintendo Switch Lite as a dedicated handheld version, and customers can choose whichever best matches their lifestyle. In terms of the hardware, I think we will be able to consider a variety of ways to expand in the future. The software is no less important. As explained in the presentation, our focus now will be on the Nintendo Switch platform with its growing install base. By focusing our software development resources on Nintendo Switch, I believe its lifecycle will follow a course that is different from our previous Nintendo home consoles. Now, for those of you who don't know, the average lifecycle for a Nintendo console is about 5 years, as you all can see in your screens here, and this goes all the way back to the original Nintendo console which debuted in 1985. And this doesn't include any of the handheld consoles, but as stated by global president Shuntaro Furukawa, we are now entering into the fourth year of the lifecycle for the Nintendo Switch, and that Nintendo will continue to push software for the Switch and not hardware. He has already also stated earlier in this year that no, we will not have a new Nintendo Switch in 2020, possibly 2021 or 2022, but even still, this is kind of unheard of for the development of Nintendo and their home consoles. And with the Nintendo Switch being a hybrid console, a handheld, as well as a home console, I think that we can expect the Nintendo Switch being here for at least another 4 years. Shuntaro Furukawa has also stated in this investors meeting that we're in the middle of the lifecycle of the Nintendo Switch. So, we just may expect another 3 to 4 years before we see another new home console from Nintendo. I'm pretty sure that we'll get another iteration of the Nintendo Switch, possibly in 1 to 2 years, a Switch with better graphics, better processing and everything like this, but no time soon. We'll just have to wait to see what the future holds for Nintendo, but the Nintendo Switch is still fresh, and software is always important to sell consoles. Better games always leads to better console sales. We've seen this with the 3DS, and 3DS had a lot of iterations of that console, but at the same time, there are thousands of games on the 3DS. So, Nintendo just may take that route. Alright everyone, that's gonna do it for this video. What are your thoughts on Nintendo's global president Shuntaro Furukawa discussing the future of the Nintendo Switch? Please let me know down in the comment section below. If you like this video, make sure to hit that like button and share this video as well. And as always, remember to keep it locked here at Around the Clock. We're here, we focus on Nintendo gaming news around the clock. Catch you guys in the next one.